In MSF, we've learned that in order to provide a safe abortion with pills, you need three things: accurate information, quality pills, and mutual respect and trust. An unsafe abortion is one that's provided by someone who hasn't been adequately trained or in an environment that doesn't meet minimal medical standards. So examples of this that we see in MSF are people taking traditional herbs or potions, even drinking battery acid or chlorine, putting things like sticks or broken glass or pen cartridges in their body to try to induce an abortion. On the other side, a safe abortion is one that's provided or supported by someone who's been adequately trained and by a medically approved method. So two examples of this are an abortion with pills or abortion procedures. People feel a whole bunch of different emotions about their abortion, and that's okay and totally normal. The most commonly reported emotion, looking back, is actually relief. When it comes to family and friends, how are you showing up for the people in your life who may have had abortions or may need abortions in the future? How are you talking about this with them? And on the larger level, right, depending on what's going on in your political landscape, how are you showing up for and supporting organizations who are trying to make reproductive health care more accessible? I think the question behind this question is actually, what if people have more than one abortion? And my answer is, that's okay. It's okay if people have more than one abortion. If we 100% support abortion, that means that we 100% trust people to make the best decision for themselves with their body and with their lives. MSF is not a religious organization. We're not trying to change anybody's religious beliefs. MSF provides impartial, non-biased healthcare to the most vulnerable, and safe abortion care is healthcare. The COVID-19 pandemic actually pushed some really long overdue innovations in the abortion field. So people started to really think outside the box and think about how can we provide this care without requiring people to come to a healthcare facility. So that's when people started doing more abortion consultations over the phone or via telehealth models, and doing things like mailing abortion pills to patients. And all those things can help us go a long way to increasing access to this essential healthcare. It's a public health issue. When people don't have access to safe abortion care, then they turn to unsafe methods. And at MSF, we've seen the consequences of those unsafe methods firsthand. People can get really sick and they die. And this happens every day around the world. So in MSF, that's why we're so committed to reducing this death and suffering from unwanted pregnancies and unsafe abortion by providing access to contraception and safe abortion care. Thanks so much for your questions and for wanting to learn more about how safe abortion care is essential healthcare.